Hi, and welcome to week 5 of stretching mobility yoga. So this week we're going to be looking at stretching out the side body. So hopefully by stretching out this area should enable you to move a little bit more freely, sort of whether that's twisting or sort of stretching through the front body. It should also help you to breathe a little bit more freely just by freeing up the muscles in between the ribs. And hopefully at the end of the class, you might also feel a little bit taller as well. So for this class, we're not going to need any equipment at all, just a little bit of floor space. And we're going to start seated. So come to a seated position. So whether that's cross-legged, you could also sit on your knees or on a chair. So sitting up nice and tall. So lengthening up through the spine and then just bringing the hands together in front of the chest, pressing the palms, just resting the thumb on the breastbone. And then you can close your eyes if you like, and then just take a nice deep breath in through the nose. And then exhale, sigh out of the mouth. So now just breathing in and out through the nose will introduce a count to the breath. So inhaling for a count of 5. And then exhaling for a count of 5. So starting now, inhaling, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And exhaling, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhaling, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And exhaling, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So increasing to a count of 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And again, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And increasing to a count of 8. So 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So just carrying on with your own count. So if 8's a little bit too much, you can always reduce it or slow the count. So just really concentrating on expanding through the ribs, feeling the opening up in the side body, feeling all of that space that you have available to you. I'm just noticing the rise and the fall of the body with the breath. So just taking one more round in your own time. When you've finished your last, just returning to a normal, slow breath, but letting go of the count. And then whenever you're ready, opening your eyes. And then just taking a moment to notice how you feel. So hopefully you're feeling a little bit taller already, just lifting up out of the hips, out of the waist. Shoulders just falling down the back. So from here, taking your right hand out, taking our first stretch. So inhaling, reaching the left arm up, up and over. So really extending through the fingertips. So heavy through the left sit bone. And then changing sides. So reaching the right arm up and over, So thinking length rather than just trying to fold over as far as you can. Heavy through the right sit bone. And then slowly coming back up. So coming now onto your hands and knees. We'll take a few rounds of cat-cow just to get a bit of movement through the spine. So hands underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. And then inhaling, lift the chest, shoulder blades draw down. Exhale, pressing the floor away, shoulder blades separating. And then inhaling, coming through. And then exhaling, pressing away. So take three more in your own breath. So really linking the movement with the breath. And then coming back to neutral, taking the knees a bit wide, heels touch, toes touch, and then just sit back into the heels, coming into extended child's pose. So resting the forehead down towards the floor. And then we're going to take a side stretch from here. So start to walk the hands over to the right. Maybe placing the left hand on top of the right and just really sinking that left sit bone down again. So stretching down the left side, taking some deep breaths into that left side, feeling the ribs separating, muscles in between them stretching. And then walking the hands over to the other side. So maybe placing the right hand on top of the left. So letting the head drop between the arms, sinking weight down into the right sit bone, stretching all down the right side of the upper body. And then walking the hands back to center. So come back up onto hands and knees. Just bring the knees back underneath the hips. About hip width apart, tucking the toes under, ready for downward facing dog. So press back towards the heels, really lengthen through the spine to begin with. When you can't press back any further, then just start to lift the knees up, keeping the knees bent to begin with, lifting the sit bones up as high as you can, coming up onto tiptoes. And then once you're as high as you can go, then you can start to lower the heels down towards the floor. So don't worry if they don't reach all of the way, but just enough for you to feel a little bit of a stretch in the hamstrings, but without compromising the length of the back. So if you feel like you're starting to round through the back, then just bending the knees, just keep them bent. From here you can start to pedal out through the feet. So just pressing one heel at a time down towards the floor. And then coming back to centre. From here, you're going to bend the right knee. And then turn the left heel in towards the centre line. So your left toes are pointing outwards. And then just really start to press in to that left hip. So straightening the left leg. Hopefully you should feel a little stretch down the outside of the left leg. And then changing sides. So right heel turns in, bending the left knee. And then really pressing out into that right foot, right hip. And then coming back to center, looking forward, and then just walking the feet towards the hands. You can walk the hands back towards the feet, coming into a forward fold, just let the head relax. And then coming up halfway, hands to the shins, extending through the upper body, exhaling, bending the knees, folding down, bend the knees deeply, reaching the arms up into a pose called awkward chair. So Matt's sitting in an imaginary chair. And then bring the hands together, inhaling, reaching up tall. And exhaling, releasing the arms. So, coming to stand with the feet together. And then we're going to take a standing side stretch. So reaching the arms up. And then catching hold of a wrist. Probably can't see on my camera, but this is what I'm doing. And then just reaching over to the right. So really pressing down into the left foot. Taking a couple of breaths here. And then coming back to center, catching hold of the other wrist, leading over, pressing down into the right foot. And then coming back to center, releasing the arms. Okay, taking the feet out wide. So if you hold your arms out, then your feet should be more or less underneath where your hands are. So coming from here into warrior two. So turning the right toes to face towards the front, left toes turning in slightly, and then bending into the right leg. So right knee stacks over right ankle, and the right knee is drawing out towards the little toe side of the foot. So try not to let the knee creep in, because that will start to tweak on it a little bit. Raising the arms out, and just looking out over the right fingertips. Taking a couple of breaths here, and then placing the left hand to the left thigh, turning the right palm up, and inhaling, reaching the arm up and towards the ceiling, keeping the right knee bent. You can always bend even a little bit more deeply. And then coming forward through warrior two, resting the right forearm gently on the thigh, and then sweeping the left arm up and over, coming into what's called extended side angle. So you're creating a long line of energy all the way from the left fingertips to the outside of the left foot. So this is where you might feel the stretch. And then inhaling, coming back up, straightening the right leg. And then we're going to come into triangle pose from here. So reaching the right arm as far forwards as you can go. Right legs more or less straight. And then bring the right hand to rest on the shin, reaching the left arm up towards the ceiling. And then maybe extending the arm up and over the head. So really pressing down into that left foot as well. And then slowly coming up, turning the right toes in. We'll try it all on the other side. So starting with warrior two. So just bending that left knee, making sure the knee's stacked over the ankle and the knee's drawing out to the little side toe of the foot. Reaching the arms out wide, gazing out over the left fingertips. So just finding your stability here. And then bring the right hand down to rest on the thigh, turning the left palm up, inhaling, reaching the arm up and over, up towards the ceiling. Keep bending down into the left leg. And then coming back through warrior two, left forearm down, right arm reaches up and over. Extended side angle. So just resting very little weight in the left arm. And then coming back up, straightening the left leg, coming into triangle pose now. So reaching as far forward as you can with the left arm. So if somebody's got hold of your hand and they're pulling, and then bring the left hand down either to rest on the shin, or you can just rest it to the inside. And then reach the right arm up. And then taking the arm up and over, extended triangle pose. then coming back to centre, turning the left toes in, bring the hands to the waist, inhaling, lifting up out of the hips, looking up towards the ceiling, and then exhaling, starting to tilt the pelvis forwards, coming 90 degrees to begin with. So either staying here, if that's enough for the hamstrings, you might be able to take it a little bit further so the head starts to come down towards the floor. You can always bend the knees to do this as well. So if you can, you can take the hands to the floor. If you can't reach the floor, you can just rest the hands on the shins. So just letting the head relax. And then we're going to walk the hands over to the right leg. You can always bend the left leg a little bit for this. If it's starting to tweak your lower back a little bit, so you're allowing the pelvis to turn with the twist. Inhaling, lengthening the spine. Exhaling, folding down over the right leg. And then changing sides, so walking the hands over to the left leg, so lift and lengthen, and then exhaling, drawing yourself down over the left leg. Remember, you can always bend the right knee and turn the pelvis a little bit to follow the twist, or just keep the right leg straight if it feels fine. And then coming back to centre. So just walk the feet in a little bit, bring the hands to the waist, and then slowly coming up. So turning now to face what is the top of my mat. So we're going to have the right leg sort of facing forwards, the left toes also facing forward, but about sort of 10 o'clock. So you might need to take the feet quite wide as well, sort of about hip width apart. It's quite a short stance as well, so not too far apart. So bring the hands now to the waist, inhaling, lifting the chest up, and then exhaling, keeping the right leg straight but not locked, just start to fold forward over that right leg. So you can take your hands to rest on the shin, but what you're concentrating on is really lengthening through the spine. So this is called pyramid pose, presumably because there's like this little pyramid shape with the legs. So from here we're going to take a twist. So keeping your left hand on the shin, taking your right hand to your waist, and from here starting to turn out to the right. If this feels okay, you can always take the hand to rest on the floor, to the inside of the foot or the outside. And then if it feels okay, you might be able to reach the right arm up towards the ceiling. Keep pressing down into the feet, drawing back on the right hip, pressing forward with the left, and then turning back into pyramid pose again, taking a breath here, exhaling, folding down, and then coming back up, changing sides. So left toes facing forwards, right toes out at about 1 or 2 o'clock. And the feet are about hip width apart. Inhaling, hands to the waist, looking up. Exhaling, hinging forwards over the left leg. So soft through the left knee, not locking it out, but trying to keep it reasonably straight. You can always bring the hands to rest on the shin, or you could bring fingertips to the floor if they'll reach. taking a couple of breaths here, and then coming into the twist. So right hand rests on the shin or to the floor, left hand on the waist, and then start to turn out to the left. Keep pressing down into the left foot. And if it feels okay, you could always raise the top arm. That's just a bit too much, just keep the hand on the waist. And then looking back down at the floor, bring the hands back to rest on the shin or the floor, inhaling deeply, lengthening through the spine, exhaling, folding down over the left leg, and then bring the hands to the hips, slowly coming up. And turning to face center, just walking the feet in. So coming into tree pose here. So standing on the left foot to begin with, and then drawing the right knee in towards the chest. So standing up tall, finding your balance. Helps sometimes to find a spot on the floor or something static to fix your gaze on. And then keeping the knee closed in, just taking it out to the side, and then bringing the foot to rest either to the inner thigh, the inner calf, or if you're feeling a bit wobbly, you could place the toes on the floor and rest the heel against the ankle of the left foot. So once you're there, then just bring the hands together in front of the chest to begin with. Just finding your center. And then taking the right hand now to the inner thigh, the right leg, and then reaching the left arm up. So keep pressing that right hip forward, using the right hand just to draw the knee out. And then coming into a little bit of a side stretch, so it might be a bit wobbly. Don't worry if you fall out. Try and keep the breath nice and steady. And then coming back to center, releasing other side. So drawing the left knee in, standing up tall, and then taking the knee out and bringing the foot in. So bring the hands together now in front of the chest. And then once you have your balance, just bring the left hand to rest against the inside of the left thigh. Keep pressing the left hip forward, drawing the left knee back, reaching the right arm up, and then start to bend over to the left. So if this just makes you feel too wobbly, you can always just stay in tree without the arms doing anything, or stand near a wall so that you've got something to rest your hand on if you feel yourself falling. And then coming back and coming out with as much control as you can. Okay, so coming to stand nice and tall. Inhaling, reaching the arms up, and then exhaling, folding down, inhaling, coming up halfway, extending through the spine, and then exhaling, bring the hands down, coming into plank, and then lowering the knees to the floor. So we're coming into a variation of side plank here. So turning your right toes out to the side, just to add a little bit of support. And then right hand underneath the right shoulder, maybe slightly ahead of it. So really rotating that upper arm forwards, just to give a bit of stability. And then taking the left leg out, inhaling, reaching the left arm up. Deep breath in. Exhaling, sweeping the arm up and over, So really pressing into that left foot as well, reaching out through the left fingertips. Keep pressing the hips forward. And then bring the left hand down, other side. So turning the left foot out, coming onto the left hand, rotating that left upper arm forwards, then reaching the right arm up and sweeping it over. So keep pressing into the outside of the right foot, keep pressing the hips forward. And then bringing the right hand down. And then coming back into extended child's pose. Resting forehead. You can always stack the hands just to give the forehead something to rest on if it doesn't quite reach the floor. And just really concentrate on breathing into the side ribs, into the back body, relaxing the hips down, and then coming to lie on your back. So, just letting the palms face towards the ceiling, letting the feet roll out to the sides. If this doesn't feel comfortable on your lower back, you can always bend the legs and just let the knees fall together. And then just slowing the breath again. Allowing the face to relax, the eyes to close. Gently following the sound of the breath. Just allowing yourself to relax. Breathing to slowly return to normal, heartbeat to return to a resting rate. And then spending as long as you can in this rest position. If this is your time to finish, then just drawing your knees in one at a time towards the chest, just hugging them in, maybe giving a little rock from side to side, circling one way and then the other. And then rolling out onto the right. Slowly lifting up, coming to sit up tall, reaching the arms up, exhaling sigh out the mouth, bringing the hands together in front of the chest, bowing the head. Namaste. Thank you very much. Have a lovely rest of your day.